Hi, I'm Meg from Professional Music Technology, and in today's video, I wanted to take you through a gear guide setup for any gigging acoustic or singer-songwriter musicians. Over here on YouTube, you can find countless videos on what guitarists should and shouldn't bring to gigs, the correct amps for stage, and the perfect distortion pedals for making lots of noise in your band. But one thing I have noticed is that there is definitely less content out there for those of us who play in the acoustic music gigging world. From my experience on the road for the last 8 odd years, combined with my experience with PMT customers, particularly in the acoustic section of our stores, I have compiled together a list of essential gigging items that you will need to get on the road and playing successful shows. So, first up, and a bit of an obvious one, let's start with your guitar. Now, I suspect if you have come to this video, I would imagine, like me, you tend to prefer the sounds and the genres associated with acoustic guitars. There are so many options out there when it comes to acoustic guitars, and one of the first things you'll want to do is make sure you have the ideal guitar for your setup. Tone woods, body shapes, plus designs and pickups all play a big part in selecting the right guitar for your live performances. For instance, if you are after a guitar with a big, full and rich sound, then you would want to select either a dreadnought, a jumbo or an orchestra style of guitar. The bigger body naturally gives the guitar more bass response. As well as that, the tone woods used on the guitars, i.e. spruce top or a mahogany top, will affect the sound and how much bass response you get. For me personally, I really love an acoustic guitar with a big, rich but balanced sound, as I tend to play a combination of finger picking and strumming patterns. For this reason, a spruce top and rosewood or a Vanco back and sides guitar would be my go-to. Something like a Taylor 414 CE or the Yamaha LSTA. If you like a slightly mellower sound, then a guitar with an all mahogany construction, such as the Taylor AD22E or the Faith Naked Venus Mahogany, would definitely be a great choice. If you're after something with slightly more mid-range, then a guitar with an auditorium or a triple O style body would be a great choice. Due to the smaller body compared to that bigger body dreadnought, these guitars naturally have slightly less bass response and a more prominent mid-range. Something to also consider when it comes to these acoustic body shapes is whether or not you will need a cutaway on the guitar. Cutaways give you access to the upper frets, which will be particularly useful if you do tend to play all the way up the fretboard. If you were after a particularly twangy or bright sound, then an acoustic with a smaller body, such as a Parlor, a 3/4 size or a 00 size would be an excellent choice. The Faith Naked Mercury, the PRS P20E and the Taylor GS Mini are all great examples of smaller bodied gigging guitars. Another thing to take into account when selecting a guitar for your live shows is whether or not you're going to need a pickup or preamp system. For most gigging musicians, having a built-in pickup in your guitar is going to be an essential feature for getting the best live sound. Having an onboard pickup or preamp system allows you to connect up to either the venue's sound system and desk or your own if you are providing the PA for the gig. Most modern day acoustics come already fitted with a pickup system and will feature onboard tone controls, volume, and for some brands, even a built-in tuner. A great example of this being the Fishman Sonicore pickup, which you will find fitted in Epiphones and Martins, plus many more brands. If you have fallen in love with a guitar that doesn't have built-in electronics, then don't panic. There is also options for you to transform that guitar into an electroacoustic when playing live. Something like the Seymour Duncan Woody, a wooden sound hole pickup which slots just under the strings and into the sound hole, is a great substitute. Just like with a standard pickup, you would plug the jack on the sound hole pickup directly into the DI or desk. Although it is worth bearing in mind that you don't have quite as much control over the sound or tone by using this option. That leads us nicely onto your guitar sound. Now, for some of us acoustic players, pedals can seem like another language made for rockers, soloists, and shredders. But there is a whole heap of fantastic options out there for us acoustic musicians too, to really enhance and bring the live sound to life. Acoustic guitars have beautiful resonant tones when played unplugged, but once plugged into a DI, either through a piezo, magnetic, or microphone pickup, they can lose some of that beautiful natural woody tone. For this reason, there is a whole range of pedals available exclusively for acoustic guitars, as well as a variety of options of normal pedals that would be perfect for use in an acoustic live setup. The first pedal option I'll briefly mention is an acoustic preamp pedal, or an all-in-one EQ and tone machine. Back when I was in the first few years of gigging, I really struggled with finding a consistent tone from my guitar between all the different venues and bars I was playing at. Once I got myself an acoustic preamp pedal, I found it really opened up my sound on stage and gave me back some of the control over the general EQ and tone. Some great examples of an acoustic preamp pedal would be the Orange Acoustic Preamp. This one has onboard EQ with bass, mids, and treble controls, XLR and quarter inch outputs, a buffered effects loop, and a notch filter to help with any nasty frequencies coming through. Another great option if you wanted to control your vocals as well, say if you're a singer-songwriter, would be the Ashdown Woodman's Pedal R. This one has two band EQ, so bass and treble. It's got XLR and quarter inch jack inputs with assignable reverb for each channel, a notch frequency control, and a foot switchable shape button. These pedals will essentially work as a mini personal mixing desk for your own sound. If it was just single pedals you were after, the most popular effects used by acoustic musicians are definitely reverb, delay, sometimes tremolo or vibrato, and oftentimes a touch of chorus. Firstly, there is a huge range of reverb pedals available, but here are my top 5 picks for acoustic guitarists. The Boss RV6, the Electro-Harmonix Oceans 11, the Fender Marine Layer Reverb, and of course, the Strymon Blue Sky or Big Sky, which although have a premium price tag, they are definitely the most advanced on the list. Next, looking quickly at delays, you have the Boss DD8 or the DD3, you have the Fender Mirror Image, the MXR Carbon Copy, the Wayhuge Aquapus, and the king of delay pedals, the Strymon Timeline. And lastly, some great chorus options include the Boss CH1, the MXR Analog Chorus, the Electro-Harmonix Nano or Small Clone, or for a super affordable but great sounding option, there's the Moore Ensemble King. You could choose to go for all of the above sounds, just one of them, or you could have your own selection of effects. But having those with you on stage will, in short, lift your sound from that of a plugged-in acoustic to a tonal choice. The next thing I wanted to touch on is the accessories you'll need when you are gigging as an acoustic musician. First on the list, you'll obviously need something to carry that guitar to the gig with, so a gig bag or a hard case will be essential. There is a wide variety of different padded gig bags available, ranging from $19.99 up to $45. depending on how thick you would like that protective padding inside to be. If you are going to be on the road extensively and feel like your guitar might need extra protection from being lifted in and out of vehicles, loaded into gig venues, or flown overseas for a show, then you will definitely be better off considering a hard case. They may be a little heavier to carry, but they definitely offer more long-term durability and safety for your guitar, especially when you are on the road. A tuner would be another essential in your gigging kit, either the clip-on headstock kind or the pedal tuner kind. Clip-on tuners are an inexpensive and easy to use option. Something like the Snark ST range or the Daddario Planet Waves clip-on tuner range would all be good options, coming in at under £25. A real advantage of a pedal tuner though is that once it's on, it will bypass the signal and mute your guitar. This just saves the audience from hearing you as you tune up. A few great options of pedal tuners would be the Boss TU3, the Korg Pitch Black, or the Electro-Harmonix EHX 2020 tuner. These can join onto your existing pedal board, being the last pedal in the chain before your guitar, using your foot to control it as you would the rest of your board. If you are going to be using pedals and plugging in the guitar, then you will obviously need a couple of guitar cables. A 3 meter or 6 meter standard instrument cable would be ideal. We all know the stories of how much it upsets the sound engineers when they hear the dreaded, "Sorry, can I borrow some cables? I forgot mine." So make sure you pack your cables too. Other things that may come in handy on stage would include a capo, should you want to use one in your set, plectrums, and something that is super handy is one of the Dunlop plectrum holders. I find these particularly useful for that odd moment you accidentally drop your pick and there's another already lined up in front of you, connected to the mic stand. The last couple of things to consider is whether or not you're going to bring a stand along with you. It's not always reliant that a venue will have a stand on stage, and it looks super professional to have your guitar upright and ready to go before you play. So a stand of either the A-frame or the upright kind would be a great addition. And lastly, how are you going to stand up and rock out on stage if you don't have a strap on your guitar? Make sure you pick out a cool strap to go with your acoustic so you have the freedom to move around as you wish on stage. With all of that in mind, finally, it's worth remembering to bear in mind, particularly if you are a solo gigging musician, that you are going to want to be able to carry all of this equipment. I know I've certainly been there before, where I've bought out a few guitars, a pedal board, stand, mic stand, and it all became a bit of a juggling act. If you do have a car, this bit will obviously be a lot easier to manage, but if you'll be traveling to your gig using public transport, making sure you have suitable cases that aren't too heavy and that you can condense your kit into a solo gigging setup is essential. So that was my quick rundown of the go-to acoustic musician or singer-songwriter gear guide. If you are heading out on the road this year and you weren't too sure what you need to have in your setup, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did want to find out any more information about any of the products I've mentioned in this video, you can head to our website, pmtonline.co.uk, or you can pop down to your local professional music technology store and have a chat with one of our acoustic experts. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Head over to our socials at PMT House of Rock and give us a big follow. I've been Meg, and I will catch you all soon.